Hello everybody, this is Lollypop081MLE here today, and welcome to another episode of Lollypop Speed Art and Michael Jackson Month. This time we are doing MJP, The Bad Error. Now, The Bad Error for a lot of MJ fans is like one of the, Michael's best error in history, because while Michael went on tour for the first time as a solo artist without his brothers, because remember, Victory Tour was the last time Michael toured with his brothers. And Bad performed well when it was released in 1987, but the problem here was it didn't do as well as Thriller. Because Thriller still remains the best-selling album of all time, and the Bad album did just as well, but not the best-selling album of all time. But with that being said, Bad still set some records that, as we all know, while Thriller set a record for 7 top 10 singles, Bad had more singles than that. But with Bad, let me pull it up for a second, Bad album. There we go. So with the Bad album, it sold over 30 million copies, and with Bad, it had 7 top 20 singles and 9 out of 9 singles and 5 record-breaking number 1 singles that included Bad, the title track, The Way You Make Me Feel, I Just Can't Stop Loving You, Dirty Diana, and of course, Man in the Mirror. It was the best, by 94, it was the second best-selling album of all time at the time, looking at it right now, behind Thriller, which sold over 25 million copies, and it was promoted with Moonwalker, which was the film that included Speed Demon, Leave Me Alone, Man in the Mirror, and Smooth Criminal, and it was the best-selling home video at the time. And as for the Bad Tour, which, yes, I used the one for Wembley for my piece, Bad had one of the best grossing world tours, because again, it was Michael's first world tour. It grossed over $25 million, and it was the highest grossing solo concert tour in the 80s. Oh, and you want to know what the adjusted for inflation or whatever, it's equivalent to $254 million in today's money. Now that's a lot of money. And the record, 7 sold out shows at Wembley. And oh yeah, Princess Diana actually attended one of the concerts. And mentioned that Dirty Diana was her favorite song, by the way. And by the way, with this outfit, this wasn't my first attempt. I did this back in 2012. But it didn't get off the ground, because again, I wasn't a noob. I wasn't as proficient as I am today. Let's just say that. And I noticed another artist on DeviantArt actually did this, but put Thriller Era MJ instead. So I'm like, wow. But anyways, before I continue forward, all 3 of these pieces in this part are up on my DeviantArt page at lollypop081MLE, linked in the description below. Bad was nominated for 6 Grammy Awards, and it won an award for Leave Me Alone for Best Video. He received the first Spotlight Award from the Billboard Music Awards in 1989, and Bad was awarded Album of the Year. Also, Michael performed at the Grammys for The Way You Make Me Feel and Man in the Mirror. And Michael, at this point, Michael was honored the Video Vanguard Award of the art for artists of the decade. He won that, and it was MTV named it in his honor. So anyways, for the releases, Smooth Criminal, a lot of people say it was Michael's best short film because it appeared in Moonwalker, and it was longer than the one that we got on YouTube, where it's just the Smooth Criminal scene, or Michael's at the club, and again, trying to be some bad guys in the film. But the short film itself from in the Moonwalker film was over, let's just say, half hour long, just as long as the Ghost short film. And again, I have to say this, Michael would have been he would have fitted well with doing movies, to say the least. Michael is a good actor. The last time he acted was in The Wiz in 1978. So with the release of Bad, Michael's appearance began changing a lot because of vitiligo, which he was diagnosed in the 80s, in the early 80s, and before that it was manageable because I believe Michael used concealer and foundation that matched his skin tone. But once the splotches from vitiligo, all that stuff, he had to even out his skin tone at bleaching his skin. Also, he had some surgery. His nose was perkier, his complexion was fairer, as we all know from vitiligo, and he had a cleft chin. And also, with that, it was more edgier than Thriller. And although Bad did not perform as well as Thriller did, that is still one of the best albums of all time, even though it's not my personal favorite. It had a lot of influence, it has a lot of 21st century appeal, it had Bad 25 came out in 2012, just like how Thriller had Thriller 25 in 2008. Yeah, it was amazing. And I actually watched the Bad 25 documentary, so it was nominated for the Grammys and whatnot. He had a lot of accolades and had Bad 25, so it was a very big deal going on. Oh, here's Smooth Criminal MJ complete. And by the way, with Smooth Criminal, that was the first time we saw Michael do the lean. Now here is Leave Me Alone MJ. Now Leave Me Alone's short film was basically Michael's FU to the tabloids. And Michael would always, basically at that point, aside from wanna be starting something, Michael would be making his comments and basically be calling out the media. Now with Leave Me Alone, there were a couple different three options aside from the one I went with. In the Leave Me Alone short film, Michael has this tropical shirt with a long sleeve pink shirt underneath in a plane or whatever, and then there was Michael laying, basically being like the centerpiece of an amusement park, and the outfit is like another military outfit. It's red, gold, brocade, and whatnot. And the one I went with is Michael in this white, in this black shirt with a white shirt underneath, black vest, this black bowler hat, and tartan, this brown, these slate-ish, brownish pants with a wrecking ball in the short film. So that's what I went with here. And again, this was Michael's FU to the tabloids, because the tabloids had been making rumors about him. Oh, Michael slept in an oxygen chamber. Oh, Michael has a shrine to Elizabeth Taylor. And speaking of Elizabeth Taylor, one of the famous actress was friends with Michael Jackson. And a lovely lady at that. She introduced Michael to Christmas and whatnot. And another thing was that she was the one that called Michael the King of Pop in 1989. And that was one of the biggest things going on. A lot of people associate Michael as a king of pop. Oh, and another thing, Michael went on another trip to the White House in 1990 and was awarded Artist of the Decade by President George H.W. Bush. So that's another factoid. That was like the second time Michael went to the White House and met another U.S. president. And before I go, like I said, all three of these pieces are up on my DeviantArt page at lollypop81mle. Oh, and I had fun doing this, by the way, doing the wrecking ball, that ball and chain, whatnot. And also follow me on my social media links, Twitter, Instagram, and Reddit, as well as DeviantArt. Subscribe to my channel. I post videos like this usually Fridays and Saturdays, but because it's Michael Jackson month and this week, I'm posting Michael Jackson videos every day for this week. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and ring the bell for notifications to be notified of when I post a new video. I do Lollypop Speed Art, Lollypop Sings, and Lollypop Discusses. I'll see you next time.